حول ولا قوة إلا بالله.
حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله الذي كتب الآثار ونسخ الآجال، والقلوب عنده مفضية والسر عنده علانية. الحلال ما أحل والحرام ما حرم، والدين ما شرع والأمر ما قضى. الخلق خلقه والعبد عبده، وهو الله الرؤوف الرحيم. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، الملك الحق المبين، وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله الصادق الوعد الأمين، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الناس، إنا خلقناكم من ذكر وأنثى وجعلناكم شعوبا وقبائل لتعارفوا، إن أكرمكم عند الله أتقاكم، إن الله عليم خبير. وقال النبي صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم: إنكم لتموتون كما تنامون، وتبعثون كما تستيقظون، وتحاسبون بما تعملون، ثم إنها لجنة أبدا أو لنار أبدا. وقال سبحانه وتعالى: نون والقلم وما يسطرون، ما أنت بنعمة ربك بمجنون، وإنك لعلى خلق عظيم، فستبصر ويبصرون، بأيكم المفتون. وقال النبي صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم: الناس معادن كمعادن الذهب والفضة. أو كما قال النبي صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم، صدق الله العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم، ونحن على ذلك لمن الشاهدين والشاكرين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. اللهم انفعنا بما علمتنا وعلمنا ما ينفعنا، ربي زدني علما وارزقني فهما، آمين يا رب العالمين. قلوا آمين يا رب العالمين. We thank Allah عز وجل, our master, and we send peace and blessings to His beloved messenger, the best of creation, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made for us, uswa'i hasana. And we send peace and blessings to His family, companions, and all those who follow Him, wada'a bi da'watihim ila yawmiddin, who follow Him in the way of da'wah and the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bi da'watihim ila yawmiddin means His da'wah. His da'wah is the call of Allah, greatness, Akhlaq-i Hamida. These are all the calls of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ila yawmiddin is until the last day. So this is a dua also within the khutbah, that may Allah make us amongst those people who call in His way, in the beloved Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's manner, until the last day. May Allah make us amongst those people, inshaAllah ta'ala. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillah, Jum'ah Mubarak to all of us. We come together, we commemorate, and we are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Gratitude is an essence of our religion. I'm mashkur to the community, mashkur to the management, the board, the imam, for giving me the opportunity to say a few words. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. It's a great, beautiful feeling of honor, acknowledgement to be back with all of your beautiful faces and the community at large. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all khair, afiyah, and goodness. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, beautiful verses of the Quran and hadith, which inshallah will be the subject of the khutbah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us in Surah Al-Hujurat, Ya ayyuhan nas, O mankind, we have created you into males and females, colors, different tribes, nations, ethnicities, backgrounds. We come together for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for one common goal, one common purpose, one common denominator, and that is to please Allah azza wa jal. And he says, مِنْ ذَكَرٍ وَأُنْثَى وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُبًا وَخَبَائِلَ لِتَعَارَفُوا. Underlining statement that highlights is the one who are God conscious. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those. And this is the promise of Allah azza wa jal. Hidayah is meant for those. Hidayah is written for those. And da'wah, the word of da'wah, is taken from those people who are God conscious. May Allah make us amongst those people. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's beautiful connection here of doing the work of da'wah, being a servant of Allah, given the sharia, sahib al-sharia, at the same time the huge responsibility of conveying the message of the Quran, which is hudan lil-nas, shifa'un lil-nas, wa rahmatun lil-nas. He went in different avenues and different ways of how to get close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as we know, he exceeded all expectations, above and beyond in excellence. When it came to the aspect of ibadah, he worshipped so much to the point that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is given some instructions and guidelines on Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Don't throw yourself in such difficulty that your feet swell up in the night and you're not able to stand anymore and you have to take care of yourself, because there's a level of moderation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking from us. So the verses of the Quran go, subhanallah, in Surah Al-Muzzammil, قُمِ اللَّيْلَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا نِصْرَهُ أَوِنْ قُسْ مِنْهُ قَلِيلًا أَوْ زِدْ عَلَيْهِ وَرَسِّلِ الْقُرْآنَ تَرْتِيلًا. He said, give half, a little bit of time for yourself, a little bit of time for your Rabb, and some time for prayer. And at the same time, be in moderation. Sometimes when he is praying qiyam in Salat al-Tahajjud, and the Sahaba came, and there was nothing better than to join the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his worship. Because the Prophet's worship was a worship not comparable to our worship. So the spirituality, the level of uluhiyah, and the level of qurbah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is on a different level. Sahaba used to come and join him in the middle of the prayer, not knowing how long the prayer will be, the length of the prayer, not knowing is it the first rakat or the second rakat. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is leading, let me come and join and gain the barakah and subhanAllah, pray together as one ummah. And sometimes the entire Baqarah is recited. Sometimes the entire Ali Imran is recited. To the point that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, do not excel in such a manner that you put harm on yourself and your feet swell up and you're not able to carry on the task the next day. Subhanallah. So when it comes to the aspect of worship, he exceeded expectations in ibadiyah, in ibadah, and in ubudiyah, in becoming a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the second aspect is when it came to spending for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran in various places, do not spend so much that you have nothing, you become in faqr and faqa, that it becomes complicated for you to take care of your own family. He said there's a moderation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala requires in that as well. Subhanallah. وَلَا تَبْسُطْهَا كُلَّ الْبَسْطِ فَتَقْعُدَ مَلُومًا مَحْصُورًا. Don't make yourself in difficulty. Take care of that aspect of the deen. And when it came to doing things for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the religion of Islam, Allah azza wa jal tells him in moderation as well. Moderation is the middle way. الْإِقْتِصَادُ فِي النَّفَقَةِ نِصْفُ الْمَعِيشَةِ. The great aspect of the wealth that is spent in something that is اقتصاد. اقتصاد is مِيَانَ رَوِي. That's the medium ground. That is the moderation. Not expensive, not extravagant, and waste that becomes israf, and not so miserly and holding back, so stingy that I don't feel like spending on family, on friends and people, the masjid, but I do it in a way that's moderation. Every single aspect of the deen, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was instructed and guided, was moderation. Worship, moderation. Tilawa, moderation. These four things passed. When it comes to the akhlaq, the character, the nobility of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, akhlaqi hamida, which Quran speaks about. And when Quran speaks about it, it has great value. Because Quran is the kalam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not the kalam of insan, rather it's the kalam of the one who created every single thing around us. The creator of the heavens and the earth. Insan, jinn, haywan, malaika, etc. The things we see, the things we do not see. The kalam of Allah. Mulukul kalam, kalamul muluk. Allah Azza wa Jalla is taking promises in the Quran. Noon, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. نون والقلم وما يسطرون. He's taking قلم of the pen. He's taking, and then he says, ما أنت بنعمة ربك بمجنون. وإنك لعلى خلق عظيم. After three قسمات, Allah سبحانه وتعالى jumped to the aspect of the أخلاق of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and the word علاء with preceding the letter لام is for البتة تأكيد, emphasis. And then علاء is putting more emphasis. لا علاء is double emphasis. Putting together means it's at the level of قسم, taking an oath. Allah says, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. We have placed our beloved messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam in the highest pinnacle of akhlaq hamida, in the highest manner that human beings can see, human beings can take drive lessons from and examples from. And this is something that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam displayed, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam excelled in that. When it came to the aspect of ibadah and spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, every aspect Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is guiding him with moderation. When it came to the aspect of akhlaq, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pumping him up. Allah azza wa jal is appreciating. And Allah azza wa jal is actually speaking greatness of him. He's not telling him, hey, have moderation, to the point that people take advantage of you. So much akhlaq, so much beauty and character, people might take advantage of you. He said, he's speaking greatness of akhlaq, subhanallah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Another hadith which is connected to this very beautiful subject of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's character, it says, اتق الله حيث ما كنت وفع السيئة قبل الحسنة سمحها وخالق الناس حسن. He said, when a person has taqwa in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, right, defined as taqwa, different variations, tafasir, we get different understanding of what taqwa exactly means. Some of the mufassirin, they write it as fear of Allah azza wa jal. Some of them say God consciousness. Some of them say, be aware that Allah Azza wa Jal is there. Allah is watching me in all aspects of my, all fashions of my life. Right? Sirran wa alaniya. Hidden, open. In the day and in the night. With family, without family. Every aspect of that, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is given this direction. Ittaqillaha haythu ma kunt. Be aware of Allah Azza wa Jal, the greatness, the might, the qudra of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wherever you are. And then he says, وَأَطْفَعِ السَّيِّئَ قَبْلَ الْحَسَنَةِ. And he says that always follow a hasana with a sayyi'ah. Meaning if someone has committed a deed that is not recommended in Islam, that is not getting us close to Allah Azza wa Jal, that is something that we feel ashamed of, something that we want to do istighfar and tawbah, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that's okay. Human beings are human beings. They will fall, they will make mistakes, they will always have ups and downs. But he says immediately to take care of that, and to wipe that, he says, إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ. Allahu Akbar. Look at the karam of Allah, the mercy of Allah, and the maghfirah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Verily, every hasanat is what? Wiping out the sayyi'at. Wiping away the sayyi'at. So you did the sayyi'at, but right away you followed that with a hasanah. You have a good heart. And he said, Ya Allah, I do this for your sake because I feel nadim. I have nadama inside of me. And I want to take care of that. I want to do something good for the community, for the Muslims, for the less fortunate, etc., etc. Allah Azza wa Jal erases, he doesn't keep accountability, rather he erases what you have done. On top of that, he's giving you hasanat, which is not just one in accountability, rather he's multiplying that. مَنْ جَاءَ بِالْحَسَنَةِ فَلَهُ عَشْرُ أَمْثَالِهَا وَمَنْ جَاءَ بِالسَّيِّئَةِ فَمَنْ جَاءَ فَهُوَ فَلَا يُجْزَى إِلَّا مِثْلَهَا وَهُمْ لَا يُظْلَمُونَ. Allah Azza wa Jal multiplies that to 10, and the sayyi'ah, if he erases that, alhamdulillahi kathiran kathira. But if he takes accountability of that, there's only one, is one to one. And then he says, سَمْحُهَا وَخَالِقِ النَّاسِ حَسَنٍ. When a person has taqwa, wherever he is, and Allah Azza wa Jal is his goal, Allah is the rada of Allah Azza wa Jal is something that he works towards in his life. And every aspect of his life, he's getting closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he follows a bad deed with a good deed immediately. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy wipes off the bad deed. And then he behaves well with people. وَخَالِقِ النَّاسِ حَسَنٍ. When he is interacting with people, he behaves in a beautiful manner. And the manner is something that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is displaying for us. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is أُسْوَةِ حَسَنًا لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرِ وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about that in various aspects of the Qur'an. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is advising us as well. النَّاسُ مَعَادٍ كَمَعَادٍ الذَّهَبِ وَالْفِضَّةِ. He said, human beings, the verse as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala quoted in, mentions in Surah Al-Hujurat, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ إِنَّا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ ذَكَرٍ وَأُنْثَى. The hadith also starts by النَّاس, O mankind, male and female, boys and girls, Muslim, غير Muslim, knowledgeable, unknowledgeable, rich, mediocre, and also less fortunate. Every single one is addressed in that same النَّاسُ مَعَادٍ. He says human beings, mankind, are like the treasures. Subhanallah. مَعَادٍ كَمَعَادٍ الذَّهَبِ وَالْفِضَّةِ. As we see treasures and mines that come out of the ground, and people take benefit from that. They make clothes, they have gold and silver, and precious stones of value. He said human beings, subhanallah, human beings. It doesn't mention Muslims here. It says human beings are like mines that come out from the ground and they give benefit to other people and they have great value, subhanallah. But where does that value come into play? How does that value come and become valuable? When we have something and we want to make it valuable, what do we need to do on that? There's some effort that's done, right? There's some polishing, there's some shining, right? There's some process that's required to come to that level of shine, to come to that level of value. So people, when they see it, they see that this is a valuable person. This is a valuable human being. This is a valuable brother and sister in the community. A valuable asset to the Muslim ummah. So he says, النَّاسُ مَعَادٍ كَمَعَادٍ الذَّهَبِ وَالْفِضَّةِ. The example he's giving, مِثَال of ذَهَبَ and فِضَّةِ, gold and silver. Human beings are given a responsibility, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is taking accountability. Every single thing that we do, and every single thing that we leave behind, is the responsibility of mankind. From the time that we're born to the time that we have to leave, we don't have any aspect, we don't have any concept, how much time do I have, right? We have some isharat in front of us. But from the time that a person is baligh, and the time that he is aware and fully matured, and he has so many responsibilities in front of him, subhanAllah, from his family, from his work, from his personal life, to his tazkiyah, his internal self, rectification, muhasabah, and community service, increasing in my tilawah, increasing in my connection to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In all aspects of the deen, how can I excel and come to the level that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has trained the sahaba to the level that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so proudly speaks about the sahaba as radiallahu anhum wa radu an. Subhanallah, those same sahaba who took promises and oaths, and Jannah was given to them and promised to them. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in Surah Al-Qalam, one of the verses that we just recited, he says, فَسَتُبُصِرُوا وَيُبُصِرُونَ. You will see and they will also see. So they will see what? He says, when people were pointing fingers at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he's majnoon and he's a sahir and he's crazy and this and that, he's out of his mind. نَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ ذَلِكَ. All of these accusations that were put on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? Because he said, I'm the Nabi of Allah. I've been given a simple message to connect people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the people went against his message. They said, it's not possible that he came back in the night and he came back with salat. And all these things, we're not going to get into the details of that. Time will not permit. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that you will see and they will see as well, subhanallah. These are promises, sometimes isharat, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now if you search online, Google, and see what's the most famous, the most popular, the most mashhoor and ma'roof name on the planet, number one is Muhammad, right? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's like, subhanAllah, where did this come from? 1400 years before, right? All of these things, maybe na'udhu billah, he's not a prophet, maybe he's a lettered prophet, etc., etc. There's so many things that now, in the world, not just in a Muslim country, in the entire world, the most mashhoor and ma'roof name is Muhammad, right? Ahmad, Mujtaba, Muhammad and Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all linking. And actually there's a benefit, people spell it differently, right? The different variations of the spelling pushes it up to the top actually. Because it's not just one spelling, rather, it's many spellings coming and making that conclusion of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Once the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a hadith comes to mind, inshallah, we'll try to wrap it up. Ya Aba Sufyan, he holds the hand of Abu Sufyan radiallahu anhu, Sahabi Rasul, right, who's given Bashara of Jannah. He says, Wallahi la tamutunna, ثم لتبعثن ثم ليدخلن محسنكم الجنة أو مسيئكم النار. يا أبا سفيان, والله by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, قسم in the name of Allah عز وجل, is that every single one of us has to pass. We don't know when it's time, but every single one will leave this life. And every single one will be resurrected again in front of the Creator who is Maliki Yawm al-Din. لَيَدْخُلُكُمُ الْجَنَّةِ أَوْ مُحْسِنَكُمُ الْجَنَّةِ أَوْ مُسِيئَكُمُ النَّارِ أَوْ كَمَا قَالَ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَّمُ. And every single one of us will either enter the bounty and the blissful Jannah Allah has created for us, or a very, very unfortunate place in the middle of the fire of Jahannam, a pit in the middle. May Allah save us from that. But this is a reality that He's given tazkira and mudhakira, reminder, to a sahabi of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at a different time, to give him some lesson that, hey, wherever we are in life, in the state of a student, you're working at the peak of your career, or you might be settling down, calming down, and saying, okay, I've worked a lot, I've earned a lot, I've achieved a lot in my life, it's time to calm down, relax, take it easy, I retired, everything is paid off, alhamdulillah, just relax, take it easy a little bit. Whatever aspect of life, whatever era of life you are in, every single one has to give accountability to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for my previous, my current, my future before I pass away. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to remind the Sahaba of this fact and this reality, that how can I keep myself connected with consistency? Right? Consistency. Ramadan comes, it's not consistent. Out of Ramadan, our halat is different. Conditions are different, right? I speak for myself. I can't speak for anyone else. I speak for my own self. Our tilawa level goes down. Our connection goes down. Ibadah and dua, the effect goes down. Right? Our qiyam, our tahajjud, our extra ibadah that we do, the connections that we have to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the religion of Islam and the ruh, the spirit that, you know, elevates in the Ramadan, it's different than the outside of Ramadan. But we remind ourselves, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ ذِكْرَى تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Remind one another, because this reminder will benefit you. And because of your reminder, maybe if someone has left their ways of goodness, getting close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it'll be a spark, it'll be a jump start for them. And they say, how can I get close to my Rabb? Even out of Ramadan. Right? These are important things I utilize for myself. And all of us, may Allah Azza wa Jal grant us all goodness. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the best in this life, the best in the hereafter. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide our children. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show us the truth. Allahumma adina al-haqqa haqqan, warzuqna tiba'ah, wa adina al-batila batilan, warzuqna jitinaba. Allahumma wafiqna lima tuhibbu wa tarba. Oh Allah, give us understanding and love of all those things that are beloved to you, because we don't know what that is. We need you to show us so that we can implement that, we can adopt that, and we can make that a part of our lives. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept. Barakallahu feekum. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullaha li wa lakum wa li sa'ir al-muslimin wal muslimat wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا, من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له, ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وبارك تسليما كثيرا كثيرا. ما بعد, فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. نون والقلم وما يسطرون, ما أنت بنعمة ربك بمجنون, وإنك لعلى خلق عظيم, فستبصر ويبصرون بأيكم المفتون. وقال النبي صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم, الناس معادن كمعادن الذهب والفضة. وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام, إنكم لتموتون كما تنامون, وتبعثون كما تستيقظون, وتحاسبون بما تعملون, ثم إنها لجنة أبدا أو لنار أبدا, أو كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي, يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد صلاة تنجينا بها من جميع الأهوال والآفات، وتقضي لنا بها من جميع الحاجات، وتطهرنا بها من جميع السيئات، وترفعنا بها عندك أعلى الدرجات، وتبلغنا بها أقصى الغايات من جميع الخيرات في الحياة بعد الممات، إنك على كل شيء قدير. اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم واجعلنا منهم، واخذل من خذل دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا تجعلنا منهم ولا معهم. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، وأذل الشرك والمشركين، ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين، واحمي حوضة الإسلام على الحق يا رب العالمين. اللهم اغفر أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، اللهم اغفر أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، اللهم أكرم أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، اللهم يسر أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، اللهم أصلح لأمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، اللهم اجبر أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، اللهم اغفر وارحم وتجاوز عن أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وأنت المستعان وعليك البلاغ، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. اللهم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى، واجعل آخرتنا خيرا من الأولى. اللهم اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين، غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا، وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان، واجعلنا من الراشدين، واجعلنا من الشاكرين، واجعلنا من الذاكرين، واجعلنا من الصائمين، واجعلنا من القانتين، واجعلنا من المجاهدين الذين يجاهدون في سبيلك حقا ولا يخافون فيك لومة لائم. اللهم ربنا أمتنا مسلمين وألحقنا بالصالحين غير خزايا ولا مفتونين. اللهم حاسبنا حسابا يسيرا، اللهم حاسبنا حسابا يسيرا، اللهم حاسبنا حسابا يسيرا. اللهم إنا نسألك من خير ما سألك منه نبيك وحبيبك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، ونعوذ بك من شر ما استعاذك منه نبيك وحبيبك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وأنت المستعان وعليك البلاغ، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. وصل اللهم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. وأقم الصلاة. الله